Joe Harris, Jolton Joe. What's up, Joe?
What's up, guys?
So, Joe, when you come off a playoff run like you guys had, and you come up just short, how long does it take for you to kind of get over the emotions of the loss and turn towards excitement and preparation for next season?
It took a little bit of time, to be honest, especially even just now coming back in the locker room is the first time that I've been in there since we lost. So, you know, you kind of think back to that moment and how difficult it was, how painful it was for everybody. And, you know, I took a couple of weeks where just tried to get away, mentally refresh, recharge, and, you know, physically try to take a break as well to get myself going for the off season. But I think, you know, the sentiment's probably the same with most of the guys on the team where, you know, Kevin's probably the only one where he had to get right back into it to get ready for the Olympics. But the rest of us, I know that we took some time off.
There's been a lot of talk, I think, unfinished business. Sean sat down with us and said that there's been a lot of individuals that have talked about unfinished business from last season. But, Joe, for you, in full disclosure, Rooks called you an old soul.
And the old souls of the group.
You've been around. We appreciate you hanging with us in Brooklyn so long. You got a young soul, a young spirit. But to think about the way that this roster has filled out in some of the gaps that you have, the amount of depth now, what is your anticipation just for the way things shake out with the versatility of all the guys you have and the way that this team is starting to come together heading into this year?
Yeah, I think Sean did a great job. This offseason, you know, it's tough to keep everybody around. You know, we knew that it was going to be tough to keep somebody like Jeff Green around. It's unfortunate you lose DeAndre. So, you know, it's two veteran presences where, you know, they added a lot on the court, but a lot in the locker room as well. But the replacements that we have coming in is, you know, they kind of fit the same mold. You know, to have a guy like L.A. back, Paul Millsap, Patty Mills, James Johnson, all these guys, you know, they've got a lot of experience, played in some big moments, played deep into the playoffs, and, you know, they've been around the block. They know what winning basketball is and what it takes.
Joe, when you think about playing with the guys you're playing with, right, I mean, you join this team and, you know, obviously you've continued to ascend and get better and better and better. When you first got here, the players you're around, they weren't these stars, right?
Yeah.
And now all of a sudden you're playing with James Harden, Kyrie Irving, Kevin Durant. I mean, these are iconic Hall of Fame names. How do you maintain confidence? Because we saw, I mean, you've continued to get better and better. It hasn't affected you in a negative way, right? But how do you maintain that confidence when you're playing with those kind of stars? Because I'm sure there's a different level of expectation from them, right?
Yeah.
And there's a feeling of like, okay, maybe I can't let this guy down. How did you kind of adjust to that in playing with these superstars?
Yeah, I mean, the expectations certainly are lifted just with the caliber of players that we have, but it's because the team's expectations are higher than they used to be with the, you know, the upstart, upcharge, you know, something to prove Brooklyn Nets. This is different. This is now the team that, you know, wherever we go, we have the target on our back. Everybody's trying to come at us, trying to beat us. So, you know, with those expectations comes a little bit more pressure to perform and to perform well. But at the same time, you know, I think I'm at a stage in my career where, you know, confidence-wise, you know, I'm just comfortable with who I am as a player. And I know what I am regardless of what team I'm on and what I'm able to contribute.
What stood out to you most about it was really incredible watching Kevin Durant and what he was able to come back from the Achilles injury last season, but the level he took his play to in the postseason, watching him in the Olympics. We see the skill set, but on his team and you being on the floor with him, what stands out most about the type of player he is?
Yeah, I mean, Kevin is... I'll be, you know, hard pressed if there's another player that's like him to ever really come through and play in this league. Kevin is good at every level of the game. He's good on both ends of the ball. Or not good. He's great. He's more than great a lot of times. He's probably the best that there's ever been in some areas of the game. So just have somebody like that you're playing with. You know, I certainly take it for granted at times because, you know, you're going through the monotony of the season. You're playing in, you know, it's one of those things where, you know, it's all right to take a step back every now and then and realize that, you know, playing with somebody that's going to go down in the history books as one of the best players to ever play this game.
Joe, what was the experience like with Coach Nash, his first year at the helm? How would you describe kind of, you know, just playing for him and watching his evolution throughout his first season?
Yeah, playing for Steve was great. His approach was definitely unique compared to what I was used to. Steve is just so even keel all the time. You know, whether it's a tough loss, a great win, he's never too high, never too low. He's like just like a steadying force for everybody on this team. And, you know, I always say this too, where I feel like his ability to connect with every single person on the roster, 1 through 15, all the coaches, it's a unique personality and skill set to have as a coach. There's not a lot of coaches, I would say, that are able to do that. And he, you know, he does that better than anybody I've ever been around.
Joe, we talk so much about this team, the title aspirations that you have, and that being connected to health and just how much health affected the lineups, guys being in and out last year. Aside from that, when you look at this group and think about what you guys are going to start focusing on in the preseason as you get into it, where are some areas that are points of emphasis in your mind for this group or for this team to continue to improve?
I think, you know, this is sort of a general thing, but I think it's about the group as a whole just staying focused on the moment, worrying about that day of practice or tomorrow's day of training camp. I think with us, it's easy to kind of look back on what happened. It's also easy to look too far ahead and start worrying about, you know, what might happen. So as a more general thing, I think for us, the point of emphasis has got to be around just focusing on the moment, trying to get better every day. And then really the rest of it kind of takes care of itself.
Joe, when you look at where the organization is now, where the team is now, where you're going into this year, and this is like a, hey, this is about winning a championship, right? That's what this season's about. You're someone who was here when that was not the case.
Yep.
What kind of, I guess, feelings of satisfaction do you have watching the way the organization has evolved and grown and the team has, and knowing that you're one of those foundational pieces that's helped get it here?
Yeah, I mean, it's really amazing just to see the evolution and to see where we're at now from what it was 6 years ago when I first came here. You know, it's one of those things, though, too, where you wish it was the same whole of the group that was here from day one, but that's just not the way the NBA works. And we've had a lot of turnover, but the one thing that's remained constant is the culture of this organization, where it's a first-class operation for the players, the way that they take care of us, the way they look out for us, and you know, personality-wise, top to bottom, you know, support staff, performance staff, coaches. They're all people that we enjoy being around and that we love being around. And I think at the end of the day, that's really what, you know, sets us apart. But it's also going to, you know, help us, you know, pave the way to, you know, a championship sort of caliber team as well.
Joe, we always love talking with you. It's great to see you back. Safe travels to San Diego. We're going to see you on this floor pretty soon.
Yep. Appreciate you guys.